And after I did this print, I noticed, so I really measured this prototype based on something here. But I tried to refine this a little bit and make things thinner. And if I press hard enough, I could break this off. I mean, this is 3D printed, not metal, so it's more fragile. But you can see that if we want to make a physical prototype and then just rotate this, sooner or later, probably these support elements will break off. So we go now to the more extruder. You wanna turn this one back on. You can see now how this is the original print. And then here I made these elements much, much thicker. Here's, for example, the more extruder. There you can see this support element is much wider compared to the previous version. I know then, while this might not really be the final prototype or final manufacturing model, but for the prototyping phase, this will actually be very usable, and we can just rotate these parts a lot without the fear of everything breaking apart. Another thing also, for example, the stamp. Out of metal, this is very strong. Out of plastic, that's very flimsy. So I increased the thickness, as you can see. Just so if we slide it, it would work a little bit better. And to do these adjustments, that's actually super easy in Shaper. So all these variations here, I just did, let's say here, I selected this one, then I made a copy, just moved it to the side, very good. For those who are new to Shaper, now this is all inside the same folder. So I can make a new folder, and then with my pencil, I select all the parts here. There are some black artifacts. That's because there are duplicates. Now keep that in mind. I have these holes, no holes there. Then I go to this folder 8. And down here, click and say, yeah, move everything into that folder. Perfect. Hide this, show the rest. Cool. So how do you do these height adjustments? It's pretty awesome. I could select this upper face and say, well, this maybe should be 2.2. And go here and say 2.2. So I'm adding 2.2 millimeters, or maybe this should be 3 millimeters. We make this really thick, because if this print takes an hour and after 5 minutes of playing with the print it breaks, it's really annoying. So when this is 3 millimeters, then this has to be 2.5, and I go to the other side and say, no, this should be 3. So this way, as you can see, I very quickly adjusted the material thickness based on these individual faces. But now, well, this also intersects, which is not good. So now I can go ahead, go to transform and move, select this face and this face, and move this one up. Another thing that's really nice about Shaper, when we zoom in, as you can see, the move steps are very precise. If I zoom out further, then instead of fractions of a millimeter, it would be more millimeters or centimeters. There. Okay, so now, so this is the way how I actually took this model and then very quickly copy and paste, adjust it, and made this model. Super easy.